1-888-346-9139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Last week, we had William Binney, former technical director of the National Security Agency, in studio with us for about an hour and a half. That's basically at the top of the pyramid. But coming up in the third hour, we're going to have a guest on who was with us about a year ago, who was at the bottom of the pyramid. And that's a very important place to be because that's where the real rubber meets the road. That's how Snowden was able to get so much because he was a, quote, contractor that had to have all the systems integrate together in and work. And that's the data point that foreign governments, corporations, and others would actually try to get in through and then monitor not just private networks, public networks, but the NSA network. You heard William Binney talk about the fact that they will not allow any monitoring of who goes on the NSA network. I'm going to say that again. They've got machine gun nests and minefields around NSA buildings as if the public would try to sneak over a fence and go in. But they do not allow any monitoring of who goes on the network so data can be stolen and be wide open. See, all this national security is there to protect the globalist takedown of America. That's not rhetoric. That's what's happening. In fact, at about 6 a.m. this morning, I was up reading Jade Helm news. When I was reading a Houston Chronicle article titled Covert Warfare Coming to Texas Sparks Some Fears of Federal Takeover That Attacks Us, and I knew what hit me like a ton of bricks, but I hadn't really said it on air. The drill, the two-state, two-month drill, joint forces, is about causing a stir and then allaying the fears and testing their psyops on the American people through the media. I mean, they admit in the document that it is to condition the public to accept the military presence. I mean, they quote in there that it's about working with local police and the general public. That's not for overseas. I've been to countless of these drills. It's been declassified. You heard callers where they'd be an Army Ranger and they'd have them in D.C. just going around in EPA uniforms, setting up sniper nests just to randomly simulate taking out Americans. It was released in lawsuits last year that 2 years before that, the FBI had snipers in place to decapitate the leadership of Occupy Wall Street. And it wasn't that they were even against Occupy Wall Street or for them. It was actually Obama funded. And Soros run on record. I should say Obama run, globalist run, Soros funded. It was about just seeing, will the FBI snipers go out and train their beads on peaceful demonstrators under a martial law scenario to decapitate? I mean, let me explain something, folks. It's on a list. Tens of thousands of Americans under different scenarios that would be taken out. And they've got large, I mean, we're talking 10,000 persons, what I estimate, hit team in the U.S., where they will task them with going out and killing someone every day for a month until everybody on the list is dead. Now, once this starts, it's not going to be easy. The first few rounds, it'll be easy to kill people. And I'll guarantee you, I'm on the top of the list. Ron Paul, top of the list. And it'll just be Alex Jones shot himself, Ron Paul shot himself, or Ron Paul died in a grease fire. Ron Paul died in a car wreck. Ron Paul got hit while riding bicycle. I mean, and you'll just suddenly, all these people are dying, and, oh, those conspiracy theorists think we're wiping people out. We're not. I mean, they've killed like 500 microbiologists now. They've had them in Houston where they, like, run over the guy with a van and then back over him in the university in a 10-mile-an-hour speed zone, and the police say no investigation. not even a hit-and-run investigation. They run over you, back over you. Nothing to see here. Move along. These aren't the droids you're looking for.
Doing, Al?
Good, brother.
Just recently started using your products. Everything you said about them is correct. Me and my wife both use a lot of them, and it's made a lot of changes in our lives here.
Well, thank you, brother. It's because it also funds our operation, but doing that, I know I've got to have the highest quality. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals.
We do the Super Male and the Super Female Vitality. Big changes, a lot of energy. We've gotten off of the cheap energy drinks, energy shots. Saving a ton of money there.
Sourced from powerful organic herbs harvested around the planet and then concentrated for maximum potency. They want to stun and dumb down, and energy drinks and stuff just cover that up for a while, but then burn you out, in my experience, whereas stuff that gets your glands naturally going goes right to the source. So it's pretty exciting, and I love it.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
Well, here in a supermarket in Toledo, you can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
We're live, broadcasting worldwide. I'm Alex Jones, and we're not in Mayberry anymore.
The British are coming! The British are coming!
Now the ride of Paul Revere set the nation on its ear. And the shot at Lexington heard round the world. When the British fired in the early dawn, the War of Independence had begun. The die was cast, the rebel flag unfurled. And on to Concord marched the foe to seize the arsenal there, you know. Waking folks, searching all around. Till our militia stopped them in their tracks. At the old North Bridge, we turned them back and chased those redcoats back to Boston Town.
And the shot heard around the world was the start of the revolution. The men were ready on the move. Take your powder, take your gun, report to General Washington. Hurry, men, there's not an hour to lose.
It happened that they had planned, if the British was ever to come over here, that they'd put a light up in this high church steeple. And Paul went down there to look. And sure enough, there was the light, burning brighter than day. Well, Paul all, he jumped on his old horse and he lit out. He didn't know where he was going, but he knew he had to go somewhere. Oh, I wish you could have seen it. That old horse with his ears laid back and his nostrils wide open, sucking in wind like a jet engine, feet pounding on them cobblestones, striking off sparks, Paul holding on for dear life and hollering at the top of his lungs. He says, the British is coming, the British is coming. Get you a gun, we gonna have us a revolution. And them farmers come a-piling out of the hay like bees out of a beehive. Minutemen, they's called.
What's Minutemen?
Minutemen? There's fellas that had to be ready at a minute's notice. And when Paul comes screeching down the road that way, they grab their guns and hid out behind the weeds and walls and trees and everywhere. And when the British come a-prancing along all dressed up in their red suits, they let them have it. It was a sight to see. And then it happened.
They fired the gun.
They fired the gun. And the shot was so loud, it was heard clear around the world.
Oh, get out.
It's fact. That's the way this country started.
It started when the empire came out and openly said it was going to disarm the people. And that it was going to put unelected governors over the colonies. And you look at what's in the Declaration of Independence, the reasons for the rebellion against tyranny, and we are living under far greater oppression today. And the preparations for the complete annihilation of every check and every balance are being made and are being launched right now. There are counter movements as well. We're going to cover the good, the bad, and the ugly here. That's the commitment you get from yours truly, Alex Jones. Thank you so much for joining us on this live Thursday, the 26th day already of March 2015. We have a telecom insider from the ground floor. We talked to William Binney at the top of the NSA. Now we're going to talk to somebody at the bottom. And when I say the bottom, it's not really the bottom, because sometimes the bottom's the top when it comes to actually being able to get into the infrastructure and know what's really there. It's where the rubber meets the road is where you find reality. We've had the whistleblower insider on before, about a year ago. He's going to be joining us coming up in the third hour, James Knox. Hadn't been on with us in over a year. And, of course, he was breaking down the Snowden grid, the Snowden documents that showed the infrastructure specifics. We know about the technology and how it works, but he was going over the specifics from the ground level and confirming and adding to the information we had from the first Snowden major data dump. We'll also get his take on what he thinks Snowden's talking about when he says he may release information that will bring down Western governments. I don't know. They've psychologically inoculated us where we pretty much accept anything. They could come out and say that the president's molesting children and the trendies wouldn't care. We've really become a broken nation to where we'll accept anything. And I say that very sadly. We have to find our conscience, find our dignity again, and start to stand up against the incredible dehumanization. There's so much unbelievable news, and I'm going to go over all of it today. It's just over the top. But first, I wanted to mention an article out of BizPac Review. Uber-liberal Cosmopolitan magazine just admitted babies can feel in the womb. In a twist of irony, Cosmopolitan magazine told its readers babies can feel in the womb. And it was showing babies jolt awake and get high off the stimulant that is cigarettes, that is the poison nicotine. And they were lecturing women not to smoke because you got to take care of your baby. Well, what about, there's so many ironies here. I'm going to go over my perspective. A, you're not supposed to give pregnant women vaccines until 5 years ago. Now they claim it's wonderful that you should, quote, take extra when they know it causes miscarriages and deformities and all sorts of other problems. But then they say, oh, pregnant women get your shots. Well, then pregnant women smoke 5 packs of cigarettes and drink a gallon of whiskey, too. Must be good for you. No, it's not. But the larger issue here is they show these 3D ultrasounds that, by the way, different states are trying to ban, California and others. They don't want you to see these. This is what's killing abortion, is the 3D images of the babies. I mean, you go in and get an ultrasound now, they don't give you a super high